In this topic, we're going to talk about application insights and operational insights. So these are primarily monitoring and telemetry collecting services that we have as part of Azure and as part of our development tool set. So it's important to understand the differences between these and what gaps they're kind of filling, specifically where you would use these and what questions they're going to answer for you. So when we take a look at these, the first to come out actually, the first that was born was Application Insights. This has been out for quite some time now, and you'll find this primarily in two places. One, from a developer sense, and this is really, think about, when you think about App Insights, think about developers. These are the primary target audience for these kind of things. You know, IT as a general whole is going to be interested in this data, but application engineers or guys who are actually developing the application are going to be more interested in this data. And really, the primary vector for this was Visual Studio. So in Visual Studio, when we create a new project, one of the things that's actually right there in the GUI in Visual Studio is a checkbox that says, do you want to enable App Insights? And App Insights, essentially, if it's a JavaScript application or a C# application, is going to inject some code into your app in order to bootstrap this service. And what this service will do is, by default, if we do nothing else, we just check the checkbox, it's going to feed data back from the application usage. Who's using the application? What devices are they using? What screen resolution do they have? All this different telemetry information back to your application, about your application. How long are the requests taking on average? When they hit the home page, how long does it take? When they hit the data detail page, how long is that taking? So you can see all of this low-level detail about what's happening in your application. You can also instrument it and add your own events into this thing. So if you have business logic that says every time they go to this certain point of the application, we start a transaction, and then I want to time how long that transaction takes, or I want to see the result halfway through that application. So we can actually inject code into there and write our application in such a way that we can instrument that and be able to surface that data back to us. Now, it used to be surfaced through Visual Studio Online, but with the preview portal with Azure, now you can actually see a lot of this data through the portal in the Azure portal. And so when you go into a website or a web app that we have deployed up there, you can actually see the App Insights information, you can drill into it, and you can see all this low-level telemetry data. Now, when we're talking about operational insights, kind of a different thing, but it also kind of works together with this. Operational Insights is really, it's an agent-based system, and really what it's about is collecting information like something you would typically do with SCUM or Splunk or one of these tools. And really what that's about is, as a whole, data center capacity. So in Azure, if we deploy a workload up there, again, if we deploy a couple VMs or some PaaS instances, pretty easy to manage, right? We can keep tabs on how everything's going. But once we get thousands, hundreds or thousands of assets up there in Azure, consuming storage and CPU and network and all these different resources that are available in Azure, we need some way to kind of wrap that so that we can get a sense for how's my storage health in Azure? How's my network health in Azure? Am I over using too much CPU? Do I have too much wasted? What should I be doing? And this is a great tool that kind of surfaces that information back to some of the higher ups to be able to say, here's how Azure's doing. Here's how we're leveraging Azure. Here's how what resources we're using inside of Azure.
So are these two separate dashboards where we find this, or is it a consolidated view of all this information?
It's a good question. So the question was, are these two different? And they are, in fact, two different applications because it's basically two different audiences. One is kind of, think of App Insights as a really drilled down, super in the weeds details. And Operational Insights is a little bit more high level. It's just saying, in general, your web servers are using 90% of disk space or 50% of disk space. Developers don't really care too much about disk space or that kind of thing until it maxes out and starts causing performance issues, which then would get surfaced in App Insights. So, yeah.
So when we're doing App Insights, are we talking specifically about applications in the cloud or also on premises?
That's a good question too. So the App Insights can actually be installed in either place. Because remember, an App Insights is really about the client, right? So we're going to put something in that application, wherever that application runs, as long as it can talk to the internet, and it can talk to Azure, it will be able to surface that data back. Operational Insights is typically something we deploy in Azure. We use SCOM or something else to manage our data centers, typically off-premises. Okay. But they're agent-based, so it uses the same agent. So when we're talking about all these different things, I mentioned three things here. App Insights, I mentioned Op Insights, and I mentioned SCOM. All three of these are based around the same architecture of an agent. I mentioned in App Insights that sometimes we don't need an agent, but we can also do server-side stuff. And that's what the really cool thing with App Insights is so we have the client side, we can actually deploy an agent up to the web server that's actually servicing that request. And that can provide application level detail, and then we can have operations level on top of all that to be able to do capacity planning.
All right, so I'm gonna throw a little curveball in this. Sure. I've heard about this thing called cloud app discovery, right? It's a service out there that we can actually tap in back on premises. So is that different or just a new version of app discovery?
Yeah, that's a really new service that we have out there to be able to that one's a little bit different use case. That's really about being able to say, what are my people using? What applications are they using? We have 500 applications out here in our portfolio. They're deployed to Azure or
it's more quantitative as opposed to qualitative about the application.
Yeah, exactly. It's not in the weeds at all. It's really high level to say who's using this application. And that's really the focus of
good
the
differentiation.
App Discovery. Yeah. And so with that, I hope you have a better sense for where App Insights and Operational Insights work together. And that concludes the topic on App Insights and Operational Insights.